2014, was strangled by her husband until she was dizzy and couldn't breathe. Her 12-year-old daughter disrupted the attack and called 911, and Andre Jeter ended 11 days in jail on the misdemeanor of domestic violence charge. 9 months later, on October 8, 2014, Andre stabbed Monica 28 times while she was sleeping in her Cincinnati home, and she died on November 9, 2014. She was 36 and she left 5 children behind her. We are very determined to see this legislation passed. We've spent the last year spreading awareness through Facebook and through a petition that we set up. And we're just very honored and appreciative that we're able to be here today to all of our that help save other women's lives. Thank you.
I just wanted to thank everyone that has made this a possibility. This time of year has been rough for our family because last week was the year anniversary of her attack. Our sister survived 32 days in the surgical ICU unit and received record amounts of blood in attempts to try and save her life. And it was the hardest month any of us could have ever gone through. But without seeing her and seeing her smile and being coherent and awake pretty much all of those 32 days, I don't know if we would have been able to continue on without that little bit of validation. But like I said, I just want to thank everyone, and I know that a large group of people were working on getting this in motion before we even came along. And I'm thankful that we could be part of it.
Good morning. I really want to take an opportunity to thank Representative Stinziano and Representative Kunze for taking this legislation on. It's something that we have thought needs to happen in Ohio for a very long time now. We have been working with people across the country, and there are 38 states, as Representative Kunze mentioned, that already have similar legislation that has worked very well. I want to be able to stand here one day and not have to have legislation because of what's happened to a victim. I mean, I want to be able to say no more and need it, because I think it's time that we stop using victims of domestic violence. We just have to stop it. And I think this legislation is a great way of doing this. Not only are we taking strangulation more seriously by making it a third-degree felony, what happens when you pass legislation is it really changes everything. It'll be a time for us to do some really good training with law enforcement officers, so they, as a matter of course, start asking about strangulation when they come upon the scene. We know that strangulation can obviously result in ultimately homicide, but it can also result in very severe injuries, sometimes that aren't present at the scene. And so the other thing we have to be able to do is make sure that women get the medical help that they need immediately, as well as the legal help that they need immediately. I can't say strongly enough how very dangerous strangulation is, and how we really have to take it seriously and look at it as a high lethality factor in these cases of domestic violence. And I know that we have a couple people that can talk more about both the legal side and the medical side, so I want to give them an opportunity.